Hey everybody, what's up and welcome back. Today I have a video for you on the, as far as my haul, it's a small haul, I'm just going to give you a heads up, from the Rouge Holiday Preview Event, and then just go into some thoughts as to why I am finding this holiday beauty season to be very disappointing. So, you know, those tides can turn, but who knows, that's what I feel up to this point. So if you're interested in seeing how the event went, what I picked up, and my thoughts as far as holiday beauty 2019, then just keep on watching. All right, y'all, so I really did go super conservative. A couple of these things are actually products that released the day before the event, so it just was the perfect time to pick them up. But first off, I will tell you that my location, which is the La Cantera location, they always do things so amazing, and I love the ladies at that location. So Michelle, Diana, not sure if you'll ever see this, but I love your store and I love you guys. You're so amazing. You're always so wonderful. They did everything the way I remember these holiday preview events to go. They had a table with pastries and they had coffee and just everybody is so attentive and so kind. So moving on to the actual like product availability, but what was for preview, like we have already gone over that in a video I did a couple back that I already kind of told you that I wasn't super excited about a whole lot of stuff. And I mean, that stood true. I mean, everything was out that was expected to be out and everything. But there's something about this holiday season and beauty releases that I'm seeing that I'm just like, usually by now I'm like beyond over the moon excited, and I am kind of bummed. I will give you more on that here in a while, but let's just go ahead and go into what I picked up, and then I'll talk about why I'm just getting really disappointed. So first off, if you bought $75 or more, you got like a duffel bag. It looked super cute in the picture, and I don't know that I'm super excited about it. It's that material that after a while it starts cracking and stuff. So I don't know. I might move this on. Anyways, so that was that. As far as the products that I picked up, this particular one, I really only meant to buy one product, and then I did get like caught up in the whole FOMO and picked this one up. So I did pick up the Drunk Elephant Shelf Respect. I really wasn't going to because of the reviews I was seeing on Sephora's website about the, what is this called, the C-Firma Day Serum. But then, of course, you think, well, I kind of still want to try it out, and if it just doesn't work out, then we'll go from there. But this was selling out like crazy. There were only a couple left by the time I left the store. So I did want to pick it up just because I love my baby facial, and I thought, you know, I originally had said that if Drunk Elephant came out with a set, I was really intrigued to pick it up. So it does come in this. Now you can peel this top layer off and it's more of a mirrored look. I haven't done that yet. It's a little shelf. It's super, super cute. It has a little handle right here. You open it up, and let me take this thing out real quick. You open it up and you do have your products in here. So it came with the full size of the C-Firma Day Serum. I got a deluxe size of the Umbra Sheer, what is it, Physical Daily Defense SPF, the Poly Proteiny Polypeptide Cream, the Bee Hydra Intensive Hydration Serum, and then the D Bronzy. So definitely deluxe sizes. This was $88, and this thing is $80 alone. So if you are a fan of the brand, then you already know these sets are right up your alley and are for you. So I did use this today, this morning, mixed with my sunscreen. So I think it's just gonna, time will tell kind of thing, if I really do like this. A lot of what I see is that this goes bad really quickly. I think it's because of the like vitamin C that typically goes bad. There's a little sign at Sephora next to this product that says this, you know, don't stock up on this. This is meant to be used like fresh, so you wanna use it up before you're going out and stocking up on more, because it does go bad. But we'll see. Again, look at the little flowers. It's so cute, like the neon green flowers, and then the little shelf is neon green. Super, super cute. This is one of the better sets that I have seen like in the past couple of years, like as far as packaging and what it comes with. So I did pick that up. The next thing I picked up from the holiday lineup was the Free Lover Palette by NARS. This is what the packaging looks like. I didn't do my research on this prior to picking up, and I'm kind of bummed that I didn't. Here's what it looks like. I had told y'all in that video of what was intriguing me about, you know, the products in this preview that came in a pretty glittery pink cover. I will go into that here in just a bit as well, but just so that you can see the inside. I'm not going to swatch it again. I will tell you why here in a little bit, but here is what it looks like in case you are interested. That is the range of shades. You do get Disco Nights Highlighter, and as far as blushes, you get Luster, Final Cut, Crave, Amour, and Loves Me. So that is the NARS palette. What's weird is that it never released online. It only released in store. I had seen it online when I was doing my video for the preview event, and then after that, it kind of got taken down, and I don't know what happened. So that was that. Now, as far as the two products that I picked up from what had released the day before, I picked up two palettes. So one of them was the Urban Decay Naked Honey palette. I am huge on, I don't need another neutral palette. There's a lot of neutrals, this and that. But the more I saw this, the more it intrigued me. And I don't know if it's because they were like looking truly metallic and that one honey shade was really calling my name. I don't know. Something about it sucked me in. That's all I can say. And that's, again, really unusual because I had every intention of skipping on this palette. But anyways, here's what it looks like. You've seen this a million times over because everyone has their review up at this point. And here is what the palette looks like. It's got some really, the thing I like about honey shades is that yes, they're neutral, but they've got that brown type of, I don't know, there's something super warm about them. Like it's not like a gold that's just, oh, straight up bright gold. There's something about it that's got that honey type of twist to it. So here is what it looks like. I'm really excited to put this thing to use. I have not even swatched it. So let's just go ahead and take a look. Ooh, that's pretty. I think I'm really gonna like this. You've seen this before, but that's the honey shade that really sucked me in. Let's try one more. Let's try HBIC. Ooh, that's pretty. That's really soft. I mean, from the person who used to buy Urban Decay shadows when she was in high school years and years ago, their shades have really come a long way as far as like being softer, and they used to be really hard. That's really pretty. I'm excited about this. Yay. I've seen a lot of videos going up on this, and I don't think I plan on doing a review, so what I've been doing is watching videos already, because y'all know I won't really do a review if I am, I won't really watch videos on YouTube if I'm doing the review, because I don't want it to change my thought process. I don't want to, anyways, I don't want to copy other people, so. But I've been kind of watching a couple, and I saw that I Love Sarai put up her video, so I'm going to go watch that after this. So the other one, this is the last product in my haul. This is the Melt Radioactive palette. Now, I will tell you, I did not ever pick up any of their stacks, so I am not familiar with that formula. I do have a couple of their regular palettes, but as far as their stacks, especially the neon one that this represents, I never picked that up, so I wouldn't be able to even tell you if it's any kind of close. I will tell you, the packaging is everything. It's got this like super, it's sparkly, but it looks radioactive. I don't know even if it's gonna come across to you on camera. It might look just like your everyday kind of just material, but there's something that's so metallic and shiny about this. It's very, very satisfying. Like if anything, I would have bought this for the packaging probably, which is so wrong. Anyways, this is what this looks like right here. I did feel like it was a little bit pricey for what you get. You get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. You get 8 shades, and I think it was $48. And so I might be wrong on that, but I believe it was. And so this is one of the pricier ones. I typically like to pay $48 for something that comes with like 12 or 15 shadows. But I do love neon shades. I also really like the eyeshadows that Melt produces as far as their palettes. So we'll see. I don't know. Let's swatch a couple of these. These are, ooh, that's a really good neon pink. I am, what was I gonna say? I felt like I had a thought and it just totally left my mind. Oh, these are pressed pigments. So I do know that. I don't have an issue using pressed pigments on my eye. Usually the staining goes away after just like a couple of days. So here's 3 shades right there. Again, I don't know how this will perform. I'm interested to see. That looks kind of promising, but we'll have to also wait and see if this is one of those palettes that I need to use like NYX Milk eye crayon underneath. I don't know. This may be the very best thing since sliced bread as it comes to neon, but I don't know that for sure. So that is what I picked up during the holiday preview event. Now let's go ahead and go into thoughts as to why I'm really disappointed about this holiday beauty season. So first off, I do think there is such a thing as makeup burnout. I'm gonna do a dedicated video on that, but truly and honestly, I don't know how I can describe that anymore. There is such a thing as makeup burnout, and I am kind of in that boat. I mean, there was a lull just a couple months ago where I was like, I'm just kind of over it, you know? And then you start seeing things that are about to release and you're like, oh, okay, this kind of picked me up. And what that tells me is I'm just done with the oversaturation of everything that keeps coming out left and right. And I'm ready for those things that are a little bit more unique. I'm ready to be wowed by something. I'm ready for something different. And I think what's happening is brands are just trying to push, you know, product out without thoroughly thinking things through. I may be totally wrong on that, you know? But gosh, so here's the thing. I didn't do my research on this little palette, and so if you are a collector or if you've purchased the last few NARS palettes, this is especially for you. So I did not do my research on it, told you it had a pretty little pink glitter cover, so let's start with that. The pink glitter cover is literally like a, what feels like a sticker on there or something, and it's that rough kind of glitter. It's very unlike what I know NARS packaging to be. Just NARS usually wows with their packaging. If you remember last year, it was that spiky kind of cover. I wanted it just for that, and it just really drew me in. This, to me, is just cheap. I don't like it because of the cover. That's not even going into the product inside. I'm just like, okay, yeah. Anyways, slap that thing right on and push them out. Next, when I got home with this, I don't know why I had not thought to do my research prior to, but when I got home, I started looking at the back of this palette and I'm like, oh, it has luster. I have luster, both in full size and in a palette. I thought, darn, I didn't check to see what I already own that's in this palette. So I went through and I have luster and I have Crave. Crave is in a different palette. So I'm like, okay, $59 that I paid for this, and I already have two of the six. That means I am paying almost $60 for four pans of product. You know what? That's absolutely not worth it to me. So quite frankly, I'm not swatching this because I am returning it. I hate the packaging. I own two of the four shades. That's partly my own fault because I did not do my research beforehand. With NARS, typically I know they'll repeat like one shade, like Laguna is in every single palette, it seems. But honestly, I didn't even think to do that thinking, okay, like it's a new holiday palette, blah, blah, blah. And when I came home, I was just like, my heart just, you know? I remember the days when I would go to these events and I'd come home with a bundle of stuff and I'd be so excited. And this year I came home with two things and one of them will be going back. Now, I'm also going to talk to you about the two, what I think are usually the most anticipated things. And that's the Too Faced set and the Tarte set that's usually at these preview events. The Tarte palette, I already knew I didn't want. The colors look very muted. They're not very exciting. And I just never find the Tarte holiday palette quality to be on par with what releases the rest of the year. And so I cannot tell you like how many times, how many holiday seasons, honestly, and I feel bad saying this, that I've returned the Tarte holiday palette just because I have not been satisfied with my purchase. So this year I said, you know what? I don't want to be that person that buys it just because, and you know, because I want to review it. So this year I thought, you know what, I don't want to be that person that buys it, uses it, and takes it back, especially when I'm already on the fence and I already know that I probably won't like it. So that was just kind of like a, it did not dazzle me any more than what I, you know, from seeing it in pictures, from filming that video for y'all, I had already pretty much put it in my mind that I wasn't going to get it, but it's like, you're like, okay, I'll go into store. If it's awesome, then I'll pick it up. No big deal. No, it didn't even wow me there. As far as the Too Faced, it was cute. It was cute. I feel like it had a couple of different shades than what I'm used to seeing, like an orchid type shade, that kind of thing. It had the little separate palette with the glitters. Truly and honestly, I see myself decluttering that in a couple of months. And I thought, again, it's not worth it for me. I would love to be able to pick it up for you guys just to review. I will be honest with you, it's very expensive to do that. I've done that in the past years, and it's, I think, what partly is attributing to my makeup burnout, because my wallet is hurting. And it's just, you know, I'm absolutely hands down willing to pick stuff up that's different, that I'm going to be able to add to my collection, and that I'm going to be able to come to y'all and say, hey, this is or is not right for you. And so those two were just kind of like a, Not only that, Too Faced does have some things that I am highly interested in that just haven't released yet, like the Extra Spicy Gingerbread Palette. There is the She Snowman. It's called something different, but it looks like a snowman, and it's made up of three different palettes. That one I do want to pick up. Like, there are things that I do want to get, but this just... this intro was like so underwhelming, I can't even tell you. Beauty Blender, I was so excited before filming my last video. I was so excited that, like, I want to get the Beauty Blender set this year. Last year's was super cute and I just opted to not pick it up, and this year I want to get it. Well, this year they released a set of shades or colors that I wasn't really excited about. It's called, like, I think, the Crown Jewels Collection. And it literally is jewel-toned beauty blenders, and like that means like the richer blue, the richer purple, and I like the pastels and I like the neons, and it just did not call my name, so I opted out of that. Anyways, there was just a lot that, you know, I'm used to going and putting stuff in my basket and I'm super excited, and this just wasn't the year for that, quite honestly. And this is the first time that this is as little as I buy. And again, one of them's already going back. So it's just very disappointing. I have seen a few things that are going to release that look pretty exciting, like from Hourglass. And it looks like Ulta has released a few things as far as like Tarte, you know, 2-3 little mini things that look cute. But I'm going to be upfront with you and honest with you. Holiday Beauty 2019, I am anticipating it to be very, I don't know, same old, nothing new and exciting. Just, I don't know, disappointing is really the word for it. And again, maybe my makeup burnout has kind of attributed to that. I have a lot in my collection that I don't need repeats of, but gosh, if they could come out with a ton of new and exciting stuff, I'd be all over that. Makeup burnout would be over. But anyways, that is what it is. That's not to say there's not enough that releases in the year to be able to, you know, tide us over. There really is. So that's my take on that, you guys. Let me know in the comments below if you feel the same. Heck, you might be thinking you're super excited about this holiday beauty season, and that's okay. Like, we're probably at different parts of our makeup game. You know, maybe you're just starting out. Maybe, you know, this is one of the first times you're participating in all this, and that is so exciting, and I love that. I remember and love that feeling. Maybe you already have a lot in your collection and you just really love collecting the holiday makeup. I think that's fantastic too. I'm very excited, and hope that you get everything that you want. This is just my opinion, and everybody thinks and feels differently, and that's okay. So do let me know in the comments below how you feel about this holiday beauty season. Are you super excited about it? Are you kind of like me and you're like, kind of over it? Let me know, you know, and I'd be more than happy to admit, hey, the tide's turned and there was a ton of stuff that released that I loved and I'm super excited about. And so we'll see if that happens. You know, some brands have not yet posted what they're releasing for the season, Fenty being one of them. She's releasing the Glossy Posse, which I am excited about, but I'd like to see what else she's going to come out with. I'm excited to see what Anastasia Beverly Hills is going to come out with. Hourglass, I am very intrigued with their holiday lineup. So there are a few things that, yes, I am looking forward to, but we will, you know, we gotta wait and see. You know, at this point in time, this is how I feel. This is how my emotions are. All right, my friends, I hope you found this video helpful, enjoyable, hopefully not too depressing. I hope you'll give it a thumbs up if you did find it helpful, and I hope you'll consider subscribing. I would hate for this to be the first and last time that we see each other. I really would love to be able to talk more makeup with you. Just because I've got a little bit of makeup burnout does not mean that this is all gonna go away, because I do still love makeup. Just being a little more selective is all. Alright guys, I hope you enjoyed again, and I do real quick want to give you the verse of the day. Today's comes from Proverbs 3, 5, and 6, and it says, "Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge Him, and He will make your path straight." I love that verse. That's really one of my favorites, and I have to remind myself of it very frequently. Alright guys, thanks again for watching. Take care. I hope you're having a most wonderful day, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye everybody!